Because of the tremendous number of marine bacteria and phytoplankton out there, they have an enormous influence on the carbon cycle and the nitrogen cycle and the other elemental cycles that facilitate all life here on Earth. I'm Jeff Bowman. I'm a biological oceanographer at Scripps Institution of Oceanography at UC San Diego. Scripps is almost unique in having the ocean in such close access. We can go out in ships to sample, but we can also just go right out to the Scripps Pier and collect our samples and bring them back to our laboratory within just a couple of minutes. So some of the big questions in my field are, how does this massive amount of diversity that we observe among marine microbes give rise to the actual ecological functions that we see? So we use some newer techniques, including flow cytometry, to actually count and characterize on an optical scale cells that we observe out in the environment. Once we've approximated the abundance of the microbes, we then are very interested in who those microbes are and what their metabolic capacity might be. So the way that we get at who's there is to actually collect that biomass on a filter. We extract the DNA from it to sequence particular genes, or in some cases, whole genomes from those samples. We've been very active in the Antarctic, particularly along the Western Antarctic Peninsula. And we have a project right now to try to understand how phytoplankton are dealing with the rapid shifts in sea ice in that region. In addition, we started some new work in Ecuador. It was one of the largest mangrove reserve systems left in the world. So we look along stress gradients within the mangrove forest. For example, gradients of sewage effluent or gradients in salinity. We're really interested in the health of the microbial communities along that gradient and how that might be impacting the health of the mangrove forest itself.